What is the best prosumer 360 camera if you want to upgrade from consumer to lens 360 cameras like the Instar 360 ONE X2, Coolcam 8K, or the GoPro Max? The professional 360 camera market is very quiet for a while, as 8K 360 is the new standard for professional 360 video thanks to the release of Oculus Quest 2 right here.
Oh, I actually feel like I'm at the club.
Till today, the best next level 8K 360 camera for professional are Instar 360 Pro 2 or the Kandao Obsidian. Both are now 2 years old camera. Camera technology has been growing rapidly in the past 2 years. Now, we have new Sony CMOS sensor that can deliver better low noise image in a smaller size. We have the new H.265 compression technology that allows 10-bit color depth, as you can find in the Instar 360 Titan or the Coolcam 8K. We have image stacking technology for virtual tool photographers like the Coolcam DNGA or the Instar 360 ONE R Nightshot that produce stunning low-light 360 photos. All these new features are missing in the prosumer world until now, introducing a new player, Techie 360 Anywhere. If Instar 360 Titan is the Red or RE of the 360 camera, then Techie, the maker of 360 Anywhere, consider this as the DSLR of 360 camera. As a freelance 360 filmmaker, content creator, or high-end virtual tool creator, should you invest in the 360 Anywhere? Well, we will find out in this video. Let's go! Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the YouTube channel dedicated to 360 VR video and immersive storytelling for everyone. This 8K 360 camera can probably produce one of the best looking 8K monoscopic 360 video with minimal stitching and post-production costs. As a no BS reviewer that worked for you, my viewers, I can tell you the reason why I am getting this camera is because it's live streaming image quality. I am not even talking about 8K, just 4K on YouTube VR or Facebook 360. This camera by far has the best image quality, and you can even live stream in 60 frames per second. If you have not, I would highly recommend to check out my recent live stream with Grammy winning songwriter Prince right here on Creator Up. Watch it on your Oculus Quest 2 VR headset, and you know exactly what I am talking about. 360 Livestream is one of the easiest ways for content creators or business owners to make money during COVID, as you saw my video right here. So this is very important. So why Techie 360 Anywhere has a better image quality in life compared to Instar 360 Pro 2, LED Panel Pilot 1 EE, and even the Coolcam 8K Enterprise? Let's get a little technical here and talk about encoding, decoding, and compression, and data flow during 360 livestream. Traditional camera like the Instar 360 Pro 2 right there, they actually cannot do in-camera stitching in 8K quality during live. So they have to compress each camera data in H.264 in a max bitrate of 50 megabits per second and send that data to an external stitcher like Voices or cloud-based stitcher to stitch. The external stitching computer cannot immediately understand your data, so they have to decode the H.264 into raw format, stitching that into 8K or 4K, re-encode them, and push it onto your RTMP server, which will be your YouTube VR or Oculus or Facebook 360. So we have two encoding and compression of image quality loss. 360 Anywhere use camera internal raw sensor data to stitch. Each Sony CMOS sensor has about 3 gigabit per second data transfer internally using MIPI, and data are stitched raw in 10-bit color depth, and then encode and compress in either ASTOC-264 or even ASTOC-265, supported by a selected AKVR headset. And then the data pushed to your RTMP server, so it only has one encoding. That's why the image quality is so much better. According to this professional livestream tutorial, you can even stream to two YouTube channels or YouTube and Facebook 360 combo simultaneously. This means more money you can make using livestream. So, does that mean Techie 360 Anywhere a better 8K livestream camera than CoolCam 8K Enterprise or LED Panel Pilot 1EE? Well, not necessary. If it is 4K livestream, then yes, 360 Anywhere is the best. But in 8K, directly livestream into an 8K VR headset like the Skyworth S1, 360 Anywhere can only reach 20 frames per second. CoolCam 8K Enterprise is the only camera that can livestream 8K in 30 frames per second. For sport event broadcasts, having 30 frames per second is important with a VR headset. Enterprise with software like CoolCam Live can do PIP, picture in picture, from a 2D DSLR, which is also very necessary for professional ESPN live broadcasts. For LED Panel Pilot 1EE, they have deployable software called PI Player that can livestream in 8K in any VR headset support APK. So potentially, it will be the only VR camera that can livestream 8K on the brand new Oculus Quest 2 right here. And don't worry, all this will be covered in my next tutorial. Okay, if you don't care about VR live streaming, how is the 360 video quality compared to CoolCam 8K Enterprise and the InStar 360 Pro 2? Well, we'll bring all three cameras and hike up to Hollywood Hill to do a side-by-side image quality comparison in the exact same camera setting to really find out the image quality differences.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, action.
So what, start walking?
Not yet, just hold it. Okay. Yeah, for 15 seconds. And then look behind you. Look at the horses. Flip your hair like Instagram star. I was kidding, but you can totally do that. The bird. Okay, flip. Flip the car, not your hair.
Okay, here is the side-by-side 8K comparison in ISO 100. From top to bottom, we have Techie 360 Anywhere, CoolCam 8K Enterprise, and InStar 360 Pro 2. On the left, we have a 100% zoom circle, so we can see the actual scale of our model Kitty's face and the color chart. They all look really good. Definitely better than GoPro Max, One X2, or even the regular CoolCam 8K. Here is the price of each camera, so you can have a price per image quality perspective. Comment below and tell me which is your favorite and why you like it. Kitty is a redhead, by the way, or American people like to call it ginger. So, her hair color should be red, but in InStar 360 Pro 2, her hair color is blonde. There is a very subtle color shift. It is kind of a big deal though to make a redhead look like a blonde.
How did it
fail? For a prosumer camera, having color accuracy is quite important. Having 10-bit color light in the 360 Anywhere and CoolCam 8K Enterprise is definitely better than InStar 360 Pro 2. How about distant object sharpness, which is very important for a professional level 360 camera? So the Hollywood sign is in the frame, but very far away. Let's zoom in 300% and take a closer look. Before I tell you which camera is which, how about you pause this video right now and take a wild guess? Okay, I assume you have the answer already. So from left to right, we have CoolCam 8K Enterprise, InStar 360 Pro 2, and the Techie 360 Anywhere. So the end result is pretty obvious. Techie 360 Anywhere is surprisingly great in sharpness, like by a lot. You can clearly read the Hollywood sign compared to Pro 2 and the CoolCam 8K. Pro 2 is slightly better in sharpness, but it is more compressed and higher noise compared to the Coolcam AK Enterprise. Also, Pro 2 lens is not that great. You clearly see flare spot right here, and it's in all three of the Pro 2 lenses. So, if distance sharpness is what you care about, then Enterprise is not as good as the Instar 260 Pro 2, and not even close to 260 anywhere. Well, having more lens has its disadvantage, which is the stitch lines. As you see, the stitching right here in both Instar 260 Pro 2 and Techy 260 Anywhere are really bad. Even though 260 Anywhere has only 4 stitch lines compared to Pro 2, 6 stitch lines, but it is still 2 more stitch lines than Coolcam AK. And you need to rehearse blocking with your actor when filming your VR film. I will release a VR filmmaking masterclass, which will go in depth in blocking in VR filmmaking. It will really help you to direct your talent on set. If you want to be a VR director, you don't want to miss this course. One noticeable mention for professional is that Mystica VR fully support Techy 360 Anywhere, including stabilization. Using Mystica VR or Mystica Boutique is the key to getting the best image quality and best looking footage for VR headset like Oculus Quest 2. You can check out the workflow including one-click stabilization right here. If you need a PTGUI template, your boy have you covered already. Download my 360 Anywhere template in this video description down below. For audio, Techy 360 Anywhere support direct 4-channel ambisonic input using a USB cable from the Zoom A3 VR. So, no syncing in post-production, which is great. Professional features. This camera has great features that are essential for prosumers and professionals. Internal UFC storage up to 512GB of storage space. Having internal super fast storage is great. It eliminates the problem of an SD card failure and dramatically reduces the time for offloading footage on set in DIT. IP66 protection. There are not many professional VR camera has IP66 protection against dust and water. With Techy 360 Anywhere, I can finally film VR in Burning Man. Hello everyone, I'm Xiaoyu here, and I am at Burning Man 2016. Well, if Burning Man is not getting canceled again next year due to COVID. Internal and external batteries. 260 Anywhere has a 6,800 mAh internal battery that can easily last for more than 3 hours of filming. If that's not enough, it can connect to a standard Techy battery brick like right here that can extend your filming hour forever. Like any other Techy product, 360 Anywhere has no fan. It uses a unique liquid cooling system, which is so important in live stream and capturing music performance like what we just did here. So, if long hour recording and audio is important for you, 360 Anywhere is like the only choice. That is why I shot the Angel City Jazz Fest and the Prince livestream performance with 360 Anywhere instead of any other cameras. Now let's talk about that not so good points about 360 Anywhere. The first thing is the price. It is $3,499, a lot more expensive for a monoscopic camera. The second thing is the Wi-Fi connection. I'm having a hard time to connect to the camera using my iPhone or iPad, and the range is very limited compared to the Pro 2. Pro 2 Reflexa is even better, so most of the time, I need to use a 5G router to connect to the camera. It is a hassle to have a computer and a router on set just for live monitoring. The third thing is the software. The software of 360 Anywhere is not that good. It is very slow in stitching and only provide H.264 or H.265 output. That is not so very professional. So, if you are using the camera, you better have Mystica VR. Luckily, you can get a bundle deal with a full year of Mystica VR license when buying the 360 Anywhere. So, it is a very sweet deal. As the DSLR of 360 camera, 360 Anywhere capture not only good video, but also good raw 360 photo for virtual tour. The most noticeable feature is the 10 DNG image stacking capture to reduce noise in low light. In the next reviews, which focus more on 360 virtual tour photographers, I will review and compare the DNG 10 with the Coolcam AK DNG A and dual fisheye plugin from the Ricoh Theta Z1. If you are interested in using this camera for photo and virtual tour, don't forget to hit the subscribe button right here and the notification bell to stay up to date. And I will see you next time.